I could have used you the other night at dinner when I was trying to convince people that this all wasn't about the economy or economic disenfranchisement, because if it was, then his approval rating would be a lot higher. Mm-hmm. This is about something else, and that's a whole nother story, a whole nother show.
He is his own worst enemy.
But I got to tell you, it's all projection. Everything that he projects onto other people is really about him. So I am glad that you are taking the high road. And you are not going on Twitter and responding to him. I wish you would do that about, you know, some of the people who are eggs on Twitter. You know how we talk about that. Mm-hmm. But it's always good to take the high road, because, you know, he's attacked me before, and it's, you know, it's the best thing to do, because he is projecting when he does that. And you know what they say about projectors, right?
Yeah, I do. Look,
their bulbs burn out.
I choose to defer to the office. People get frustrated with me about that. I'm not going to badmouth the office. I'm going to respect it despite whether the president seems to be respecting it himself. I respond on Twitter because I'm here to engage. I'm not going to get into a tit
for tat
with the president. I love the fight. Good fight. It's why I do the job. Mm-hmm. But I think when it comes to the president, I don't really think it's my place to go back and forth. If he were on my show, that'd be one thing. But he and his people, you know, this is where the Trump man fears to tread. And that's okay. That's their choice. But I do believe he should take his own advice.
Yeah.
Well, it's easy for him to find flaws. He should look at himself, because he needs to do better.
They won't come on. He won't come on because he only wants to present a certain narrative, and he doesn't want to be challenged with facts and with, you know, with reality. So he won't come on. Listen, I agree with you. I've always said that it's tough to be in this position and have more respect for the office than the person who is sitting in the office. So I will criticize the president. You do it every night. But I will also have respect for the office. And if the president doesn't want criticism or, you know, what he calls negative media coverage, then he should stop being so negative. And he should respect the office of the presidency that's befitting a president of the United States. So far, he has not done that. And I don't think any Republican, any Trump supporter can say that he has, because he certainly has not. If any previous president, and I don't just mean Barack Obama, but any previous president had exhibited the same behavior as this president, Republicans would have lost their minds by now. The impeachment papers would already be drawn up, and they would be trying to kick at least the last president out of office already.
And look, I mean, you don't even have, there's nothing speculative about that.
It's the truth.
Look at the sound bites from the late 90s with Bill Clinton. The things that Lindsey Graham, Senator McConnell, and others who were relevant at that time, some now still are, were exactly what's being said by the Democrats in there. Every bit as justified now as they were then.
Yeah.